Hello, my name is Oscar Nierstrass. Today I'd like to give you a guided tour of Lepiter, a programmable and extensible notebook for creating narratives composed of linked text and live code examples. The Glamorous Toolkit book is an example of a Lepiter knowledge base. Each page in the book consists of markdown text interspersed with various kinds of code snippets and live objects. Pages may contain links to other pages, to code, and to other resources. The GT book contains tutorials, documentation, descriptions of case studies, and answers to frequently asked questions. But Lepiter is also designed to be used as a notebook. Whenever you create a playground or a note, you are creating a Lepiter page in your own private Lepiter notebook. A playground is just a note without a title. If you give it a title, it turns into a note. Your private Lepiter notebook is automatically backed up and persists from session to session. You can see which database a page belongs to in the footer, and you can even move pages between databases. You can use Lepiter to keep track of random notes and to-dos. But a particularly revealing use case is to document your activities and thought processes as you work, creating a narrative about your progress. A Lepiter page is composed of snippets. To add a new text snippet, just type return. To add a different kind of snippet, click on the plus button or use the keyboard shortcut. Here we have added a new code snippet. We can evaluate it and inspect the result. You can move snippets up or down or indent them using the menu at the bottom right, or you can use keyboard shortcuts. Here's a tip. If you want to know which keyboard shortcuts are active in any context, such as a snippet, just drill into the UI component with Shift-Control-Option-Click and inspect the Shortcuts view of the object. Lepiter text snippets support basic Markdown syntax. You can use Markdown to annotate headings, italics, bold, monospace text, and links. Use double square brackets to link to an existing page or a new page. Use single square brackets with the title and parentheses with the URL to link to an external resource. Text and Faro code are the most commonly used types of snippets, but there are many others, and Lepiter can be extended to support more. One of the most useful kinds are example snippets, which let you embed live examples within Lepiter pages. You can add an empty example snippet from the menu. An example method is just like a test method, except that it returns an object. We can inspect the result in a new inspector view. We can control what is displayed by adding parameters. The preview expanded parameter shows the result in place, and no code will hide the source code. You can set the display size with preview height, and you can select which view to show with preview show. Note that the resulting examples are live and can be inspected. Text snippets can be extended with various kinds of annotations. An annotation starts with two left curly braces, followed by the annotation name, normally starting with GT. Auto-completion will suggest to you various annotation types, such as links to classes or methods. You can also add parameters with an OR bar. Here too, autocompletion will suggest the available parameters. A particularly interesting annotation is a to-do. Note how the completion for the due date is shown as a widget instead of just text. Lepiter is extensible. You can add new snippet types as subclasses of the LeSnippet class. This particular class hierarchy view is an example of an element snippet. This snippet will display the GUI element behind any code snippet whose result understands as element. Lepiter notebooks are programmable. For example, you can access a given snippet with the variable this snippet. From there, you can navigate to the page of the snippet or the database of the page. You can also find a given database, such as the GT book, by its name. You can easily find all pages in a Lepiter database with open to-dos. We can list all the snippets in all the pages of the book and classify them by type. We can find examples of snippets we are curious about, such as Wordly maps, or we can find the pages with these snippets to see them in context. Snippets have their own language. In addition to Faro code snippets, there are also JavaScript, Python, and GraphQL snippets. Accessing GitHub with GraphQL assumes you have a GitHub access key and have downloaded the GraphQL schema. Then you can compose queries using the dedicated snippet. Here we query the Fink Glamorous Toolkit GitHub repo for its description. Wordly map snippets support a graphical language. You can edit Wordly maps interactively, and the state of the graph will be saved with the page. A node in a map can also link to another page. Links are bidirectional, so the page knows where it is linked from, even when the links cross language boundaries, such as here, between textual and graphical languages. Here are a few tips and tricks to use Lepiter effectively. Get into the habit of starting any task from a Lepiter page. For example, the script for this video is documented as a Lepiter page. This works because Lepiter can be molded to any working context. For example, you can add new kinds of snippets and annotations to match your flow. Use single word pages as tags to link and organize other pages. The to-do, short, and ASAP links are pages that serve as tags to link to-do items, short video pages, and high priority tasks. You can inspect the object behind a page by clicking on the Inspect button at the top. It can be useful to add your own custom inspector views to pages as extension methods. For example, the metrics view of a script page shows the estimated runtime based on the number of words. If you want to organize your notebook with a table of contents, just create a page, inspect it, and click the Mark as Table of Contents button. Finally, it's a good idea to back up your private Lepiter database as a Git repository, and it's useful to add a Lepiter database to the Git repository of every project you work on. You'll find more GT in 7-minute videos on our YouTube channel, or you can explore GT by downloading it from gtoolkit.com. Thanks for listening.